So I've spoken many times about the market turnaround month of October, and we've seen it time and time again. Probably the best example was just last year. We came into October at a low point. Everybody was sort of down and out. Investors were pretty negative. And little did we know, October was the low point. And from there, we saw the markets really take off and really didn't start to fall back until August of this year. And here we go again, seasonal activity, September being a very poor month, which we just went through. And here we are into October again and waiting for another turnaround. We have a chart here, a one-month chart of the S&P 500, and it's going to show you that the turnaround is actually happening. So for all of you investors out there that have been negative on the markets, this is showing you that maybe you shouldn't be as negative. I believe the fourth quarter, like many fourth quarters in history, will be a positive one and will end the year higher than the number or the at the level that we came into the fourth quarter at. And October, as I've said many times, you come into Canadian Thanksgiving, you coming in on a low, I guess at a low point, things turn around in and around the first maybe 10 days of October, which coincides with Canadian Thanksgiving. And then we end the month on a high note, and November tends to be one of the best months of the year for investing. And so to me, what is the catalyst that's going to get the fourth quarter to be a positive one? I think it's interest rates. I think we're going to stop seeing the rise of interest rates. We're already hearing from Fed governors that, you know, talking a little more dovish, as we say, basically saying, well, maybe we can wait a little bit to see how things go because inflation is not really moving up much. In fact, inflation in the U.S., core inflation has come down into the low 3% level. So overall, we're still seeing U.S. economy grow, seeing the Canadian economy grow, albeit at a very slow rate, a lot slower than the U.S., but we're seeing inflation fall. So I think central banks will communicate to us over the next couple of months that they're not so quick to continue to raise rates. And that, in my opinion, will be the catalyst to take this market to the next level. And as predicted, we'll see the turnaround in October and we'll see the follow through for the rest of the quarter.